Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Breakthrough Factor, Creating a Life of Value for Success and Happiness. Written and read by Henry Marsh.
It's the principle of the thing. That phrase has been around our culture as long as anyone can remember. When all other reasons have been exhausted, it's the one given for continuing on. Beyond money, beyond power, beyond glory, even beyond winning, things are done simply on principle. Our principles make us do it. This program is about principles. It's about what they are, how we get them, why we all have them, and what we use them for. Most of all, it's about power, the incredible power of principles as they interact with our personal truths or beliefs. Some of us recognize and understand this power and use it for all it's worth. Others use it from time to time, but don't realize what it is they're using. And too often, many of us leave this source of power largely untapped in our lives, as if we had Michael Jordan on the team and kept him on the end of the bench. This is not about morals. You'll find nothing here that preaches what values you ought to have, what you should believe. The focus is on recognizing that the beliefs we individually choose to live by are directly responsible for whatever quality of life we enjoy. There's just no getting around that. That's life. The key to enjoying peace, success, fulfillment, and contentment is putting in place those beliefs that will best produce those kinds of satisfying results. That's the challenge to each of us, to find out what beliefs allow us to realize our personal best. I use the phrase personal best because for 13 years I competed in international athletics, and those were words I learned to greatly respect. I participated as a middle distance runner on 4 U.S. Olympic track teams. From 1977 through 1988, I was the top American in the 3,000-meter steeplechase. And now, in my retirement, I check the results every new track season to see if, and when, the American record of 8 minutes and 9.17 seconds I set in 1985 will fall. However, that American record was built upon an athletic career of personal bests. Every year I attempted to improve my personal best, and each year as I set new personal bests, I felt great personal fulfillment. Early in my career, when I ran my fastest time, it was simply my personal best, my own record. Later, when 4 of my personal bests also were American records or American bests, they took on an added measure of notoriety. But those early individual personal bests brought the same satisfaction as the American personal bests that came later. Just as I sought to achieve personal best athletically, we can seek to achieve personal best in all areas of our lives. In this audio program, we'll learn how. Through my involvement with Franklin Covey, I had become an avid student and an ardent proponent of seeking to achieve one's personal best through principle-driven behavior. It has not only become my life's work, but it's helped me to understand just how much more effective and valuable it is when it is understood. In Webster's New World Dictionary, a principle is defined as the ultimate source, the origin, or cause of something, and a fundamental truth, law, doctrine, or motivating force upon which others are based. In this program, we will apply this definition to see how our personal truths interact with fundamental truths or principles to forcefully motivate each of us. Since we form our personal truths based on what we believe will meet our needs, we will use the term belief interchangeably with personal truth. The same power drove Benjamin Franklin to all of his accomplishments more than 200 years ago. And that same power can drive us to the lives we'd like to have. Together, we'll walk through the whys, the wherefores, and the how-tos of meaningful change, and uncover what truly motivates us, what drives us in our lives. We'll look at those things that produce unhappiness in our lives, as well as happiness, and realize just how much control we have over both areas. First, we'll look at a very powerful behavior model called the Franklin Covey Reality Model. a device that enables us to better see what drives us in our lives, what motivates us, and why we behave the way we do. The reality model can help us to identify our personal truths and put us in a position to change any beliefs that aren't correct for our life goals. And by changing those beliefs, we'll drive the behavior that will fulfill our potential. We'll look at specific steps we can take to achieve our personal best through principle-driven behavior. We'll look at things we can do to build ourselves up. We'll look at ways we can take control of those events that cause anxiety and contribute to feelings of little or no control. Most important, we'll look at time-proven ways to effectively form new and correct beliefs and eliminate those incorrect beliefs that produce unproductive behavior, undesirable results, and feelings of despair in our lives. This power we are about to explore has helped me appreciate the ability we all have to control our own lives, to become our best. Needs. We all have them. We all try to satisfy them. They compel us. They prod us. They motivate us. They captivate us and provide the impetus for everything we do. It is the reality of needs that causes us to develop our personal truths in the first place. But many of us aren't even conscious of what these needs are. Sometimes it's not until we look backward that they come into clear focus. As humans, we are driven by four basic needs, needs that are fundamental to the reality model: the need to live, the need to love, the need for variety, and the need for self-worth. Fulfilling these needs, or trying to, is what causes us to do the things we do. When we're successful at meeting these needs, life is satisfying. It's great to be alive. We have hope, enthusiasm, zest. We look forward to tomorrow. When we're not successful, and it's amazing how out of sync we can get, when even one of the four basic needs isn't taken care of, life is often just the opposite. It can be drudgery just to get out of bed and start the day. The first of these needs, the need to live, is basic physical survival. In primitive times, the need to live was revealed in daily efforts such as finding food, shelter, and protection. In modern times, the need to live is revealed in such ways as our concern for our finances, our health, our clothes, and our homes. We have a need to feel comfortable and secure, to avoid as much as possible those dangers that threaten our ability to simply live. The need to love is the desire we all have for intimate relationships. In general, it's a social need. It's the need to share life with another, and it manifests itself in the time and energy we spend searching for, developing, and maintaining relationships with others. The third need, the variety need, is the spice of life need. This is the desire for the things that make our lives fun and interesting. It's what we get excited about, what we choose to do in our spare time, what we find rewarding and fulfilling. Sameness bores us. Even if we don't realize it, we go to great lengths to satisfy this need for variety. It's a major factor in our job selection. It's why people bungee jump or skydive, collect stamps, or any of thousands of other things that bring diversity to life. The fourth need, the self-worth need, is the one I think is most compelling for us today. It gives meaning to our lives. It is who we are in the world we live in. It is also our need for self-esteem, for a feeling of acceptance, for a positive self-image. It's the way we look at ourselves and think of ourselves, and the way we perceive that others look and think of us. Meeting these four needs to our own satisfaction brings us the peace and contentment we want. So it's important to understand the paths we take, consciously or subconsciously, in an effort to satisfy those needs. This is where the reality model comes in. The model isn't complicated.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.